In Kerbal Space Program, when it comes to exploring biomes in career or science mode, you have to conduct science experiments that allow you to progress in the game. These experiments rely on devices to be installed on your probes or ships. Of all these devices, there is one that gives the most trouble. It's the Science Junior. Hello, I'm Jan, you're watching Only Lightmatters, and today we are going to share some tips on how to best integrate this part in your landers. Technique number 1. Go back to basics. Let's start by a recap of the known things. This is probably the most popular lander. With such a capsule, you don't have many options anyway, and you will place the science module just below so that the diameters match. Nevertheless, with other pods, other choices are available to you. The MK1 lander can, being symmetrical, you have the choice of placing the Science Junior both below and above. Having a pod close to the ground has a huge advantage of saving you a ladder, and that's as much less dead mass. Before moving on to another proposal, let's mention this idea of using air intakes to look pretty and replace landing gears. It's not optimal because their mass is greater than regular landing gears, but I like this idea very much. We go to the next size by taking a lander inspired by the last stage of the Kerbalix rocket. The Science Junior can easily be inserted above, between the capsule and the parachute. It's more complicated to fit it underneath, however, the diameters being different. We can then surround it with the tongues while leaving it accessible, so that the cables can still manipulate it. Before closing this first chapter, I quote you this excellent design produced by yours truly, equipped with a rather interesting amount of delta V. It's the kind of flounder capable, if done well, of doing all the biomes of Minmus in a single mission. Technique number 2, cargo bays. This is another way to achieve our objectives. When the diameters are not compatible, we can put the Science Junior in cargo bays. This involves a little extra mass, but you can suddenly take the opportunity to put other elements or even extra fuel inside. Another proposal, the Science Juniors can be partially housed in the compartments on the sides of an MK2 capsule. Everything does not fit as you can see, but aesthetically, we can still achieve something correct. Finally, you can also put the Science Junior in a service module. The integration is necessarily successful, we no longer see it. In practice, it's however a bit complicated to access the device, you have to tweak the camera to get there, but it's usable. Technique number 3. More innovative. If we assume that the Science Junior is the part that bothers us the most, we just have to build the ship around it. First suggestion, here the control pod is replaced by several seats that are arranged around a central structure. You can adapt this idea with the MK1 pod that we saw earlier. Another way of integration, we can build landers with an interesting reception capacity to transport tourists, for instance. We could easily transfer them from one ship to another with a docking port placed on the cabins located on the sides. Fourth technique, give free rein to your imagination, be crazy, do anything. Here is a nice brain crack, and the amazing thing about it is that it actually works. I have a feeling you're not going to believe me, so I feel compelled to give you a little demonstration. Impressive, isn't it? I'm sure you have some crazy ideas too. Share them, share your links, your videos in the comments. I will be delighted to go see them and try your creations. Technique number 5. Disrespect. So beware, I prefer to warn, the tips presented here will not fail to make purists scream. This is not something for the faint of heart. For example, you can immerse a science junior directly in the kerosene. Changing on the quantity of fuel in the tank, well, that's up to you. But if the science junior bothers you that much, part clipping is an effective solution which should not be overlooked. Another way to be disrespectful? Tweakscale. It's a mod that allows you to resize parts. You can reduce its size to place it wherever you want. It's a nice trisco technique too. We are entering a field of virtually infinite possibilities. Here too, do not hesitate to share your perversions in the comments. Technique number 6. Combine techniques. Of course, you can mix part or all of these techniques to produce masterpieces, which will be definitely creative without any doubt. Moreover, on this subject, I'm giving you a demonstration of a lander for Duna made with Tweakscale and a recolorization of the parts. Capable of detaching from a mothership in orbit at an altitude of 100 km, descending to land, getting back to orbit and redocking. This video is now over. I hope you enjoyed it. Please like, share it. You know the tune. It was Jan from All Enlightenment, and don't forget to test his TURD-MH-BG.